All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Jack Stoch, the CEO of Globex Mining. And Jack, it's good to have you back. Welcome.
Thank you. Pleasure to be here.
So a couple of things to talk about with you today. You've moved along a couple of projects. First off, you've sold one off to an Australian company called Infini Resources. Tell me a little bit about this project. And it's an interesting one, a uranium project, right?
Yeah, it's the only uranium project we have, and we picked it up in November by staking. Quebec has got a sort of strange history with uranium projects. This project is on the north shore of the St. Lawrence River near a small town of Uanbeets. And the Quebec government a number of years ago was passing a law to outlaw exploration for uranium mining, but the law never passed. There was a company that had the project and they just dropped it. And we were able to pick it up by staking. They had done a lot of work on it, a lot of drilling and millions of dollars. And they outlined an NI 43-101 resource of about 44 million pounds of uranium oxide. Interestingly, a dollar value in the ground is about $2 billion. The only problem is the grade is too low. But there's multiple zones, and the trick is, are there areas on the property where you have a high enough grade that you actually can make an open biddable mineable resource out of the 44 million tons? Because there's 153 million tons of rock that is uranium bearing. So this company took it on. And they formed a Canadian subsidiary, Fleur de Lis Exploration. The big obstacle, I guess, is going to be social acceptability. Because as you know, when you say the word uranium, Quebec, Canada, anywhere in the world, there's automatically opposition. But this could be a very, very clean, good project. And we'll see. So they're willing to take the gamble.
And you take obviously some cash consideration, but also you keep a royalty as well, just in case, right?
Yeah, well, the deal is about $600,000 in cash and stock and a 3% gross royalty on any production from the property. So we have we get our money back in spades, and we also end up with a royalty if something happens with it. And this fits in our business model, the Amana deal we did for 15 million and so on. This is the way we do our business.
Absolutely. I wanted to ask you about another one. It's more of a smaller deal than the one you just mentioned. This is in regard to the Coconut Club Rare Earth Project.
Yeah, we have a small property. It was only two claims. We increased the size to 10. Another Australian company took it on as a secondary project, some cash, some shares. And again, this one, a 2% gross royalty. That's what we try to do, is try to vend the properties, make money, and keep a royalty. Right now, we've got 82 royalties and about just over $20 million in the bank and no debt. So, and at 204 projects total. We're a little bit of a different company.
Yeah, absolutely. I just want to ask one more question, Jack. You mentioned obviously what you have there and the amount of royalties you have, the amount of projects that you have as well. Are you constantly getting people asking about those projects, specifically from outside of Canada and specifically outside of North America? It seems like there's a lot more interest, especially coming from Australia, within what's going on in Canada.
Yeah, there's been a renaissance of interest from Australia over the last, I'd say, 2 years, maybe even three, but it's gotten quite significant in the last year. It's kind of odd because it's gold has lost some of its luster at the moment, but specialty metals and minerals are gaining interest. We have a very large talc magnesite project and we couldn't get any interest, even though it's a wonderful project, super project, super profitable. Now we've got two major producers doing due diligence. So, things are, and they're both from outside the country. So, we'll see where things go.
Yeah, it's heating up for sure. Jack, thank you so much. Appreciate the update. Well done. And we'll talk again very soon, I'm sure.
My pleasure. Take it easy.
All right. There's Jack Stoch, the CEO of Globex Mining.